point. I haven't done a video in a while, so I figured I'd do a video. And I still get asked about contouring all the time, so probably do some of that too. I'm gonna use my satin lips first. They're not super dry, but. So I'm gonna do the scrub first. And leave that on for a minute. I've been posting this picture of the new fall eyeshadow palette, and my fellow Mary Kay friend's picture, I've been sharing it, and she did like blue, and it was like brown and pink or something, so I'm gonna try to like recreate that, I think. As always, primer first. Hey, Brittany. Wow, I just put a ridiculous amount of primer on. It's unnecessary. Grab anything to wipe this lip scrub off with. So I guess I'm gonna leave it on for a second. Zach, can you bring me my, those cloth things on my vanity? They're like the white cloths I use to wash my face. And that stuff actually tastes, like, good. So it's okay if your kids get a hold of it. And then I'm gonna put the balm on next. And sometimes when I don't want to wear, like, lipstick or anything, I'll just put balm on as my, like, lipstick or whatever. Foundation on. Actually, I'll contour. I like contouring before I put my foundation on sometimes. I feel like it looks a little more smooth. And my brushes are dirty again, but it's okay. We'll figure it out. I'm not gonna use under eye corrector. I'll just do concealer and bronzer. Michelle. And one thing I've learned with this concealer is a little bit goes a long way, so I really don't have to put a whole bunch. that out first, and then I'll do my bronzer. And it's better if you get these wet with water or whatever, but because I don't want to get up, I'll just use my finishing spray. And then if you, like, after you're done contouring and putting your foundation on, you feel like you want a little bit more, you can put a little bit more on top, but I don't know. I think I like doing it better first and then putting my foundation on over it. That's good enough. And then I'm going to use the illuminating drops. I love these things. I definitely recommend them. They have the three different colors. I need to go ahead and get the other two colors. This is like the darker one though. So it kind of adds a little bit of like a bronzer effect, I guess you could say. But yeah, you want to go from like the top of your ear down, but don't get too close to your mouth. Or at least that's just what I do. I did this side much better, but it's okay. And then a little bit on top here. Like Kim K said, you're kind of making like a three. Because it'll be like that. And then Amanda was talking about how to make yourself slimmer. And the best thing you can do is like get under your jawline right here. I noticed that the sponge doesn't blend as well as my blending brush, but my blending brush was dirty, so I didn't want to use my concealer for my concealer because it makes my concealer darker. And again, we're going to be putting our foundation on over top of this, so it's going to smooth out any rough edges. So it's going to look a little crazy for a little bit. And then when you blend the one by your cheek, you're going to want to do it up, not down. Looks totally crazy right now, but once I put my foundation on and blend everything out, it'll look much better. That's why I think I like doing it first and then foundation. Okay. Now for foundation. And I know a couple of you, actually a decent amount of you, already have this new foundation. Actually, I think some of you might have mattes, and only a couple might have the luminous, because the luminous came out second. I haven't decided which one I like better yet. I thought I liked the luminous better, but I don't know. I need to wait till I get a little paler, and I can start using the matte one again. But without further ado... The thing that I think is cool about this foundation is that it's got anti-aging stuff in it. Like, I've never heard of makeup, or not makeup, but, well, yeah, makeup and foundation have anti-aging in it. So it's like, if you use your Mary Kay skincare and then you put your primer on, which also has anti-aging stuff in it, and use this foundation, you're pretty much like you're hitting all the points there. So you're gonna look young for a long time, and it's good to start as young as possible, because it's like, instead of waiting to fix the problem, why not, you know, stop the leak before it happens, kind of thing, is the way I think of it. I love this blending brush. It definitely blends a lot better than the sponge does. But I do like taking the sponge afterward sometimes for my finishing spray. Now this luminous one, as you can probably see how it's like shiny. So I know some girls like that look, and some don't. So that's kind of the difference between matte and this one, is the matte does not make it shine. So technically, if you have like oily skin, you should do the matte one. If you have dry skin, you should do luminous. I typically have oily skin, so I probably shouldn't use luminous, but I kind of like the way luminous looks, so. Okay. That's good for now. I'm going to do my brows, and then I'll see if I want to add any concealer or anything to it, but I think it looks kind of cute right now. Okay. And I'm going to, usually I pencil my brows. But one day I put concealer around them like those Instagram girls do, and I kind of liked it, so we'll tempt that again. And my brows are crazy. I need to pluck them. And I know I always say this, but... again, I'm not an expert. I'm definitely not the best person at makeup or anything. But I just feel like if I can do it and it looks presentable, somewhat presentable, then anybody can do it. And then now I'm brushing them down, which, like I said, normally I don't do this. Normally I just go with the flow and kind of fill in my brows as they are. But whenever you're going to be, like, doing concealer and stuff around them, make another line here.
Best deal of the year and September 23rd. To learn more, click, call, or visit a store today. Restricted supply.
obviously see a somewhat of a difference there. Let's do the other one. Brush them down. Amber. Brush them back up. Now we're going to fill them in. Okay, now we're going to do some concealer around them, if I could find my lid.
The lid.
Okay. Now again, I've done this like one time, two times maybe max, so here we go. And it would be better if you had like a, I don't really have a super flat, oh wait, hold on, let me think. So, like, how flat this one is, just not angled. Like, it's, like, a curved one, which I don't have a brush like that. And that's what girls usually use to do it. But I don't have one, so I'm just going to use my wand and just blend it out. Over the top. Gosh, my lighting is so terrible, I can't see anything. And then I pretty much just take a blending sponge and blend it out. I have a little tiny one that I like to use first. Wee little baby one. And just take your time. Don't have to rush. And you definitely don't want to rush it unless, I mean, you absolutely have to, I guess. I'll take the bigger one. Kind of just finish it off a little bit. So,
yay me.
Okay. Let's go ahead and put some mascara on. I'm just going to use the Ultimate Mascara right now. I'm getting low on mascara, so I'm going to have to get some more. I've been using the Lash Love a lot, so I'll probably, that's what I think I'm going to get. But we'll see. Because I use the Ultimate, like, for a year or two. I would say, like, the Ultimate would be, like, you know, like, the basic starter everyday mascara. The Lash Love could be, too, but I like how Lash Love, I mean, it definitely makes your lashes long and very separated. And then I'd say, like, Lash Intensity is, like, makes them everything, like, thicker, longer, like, the, you know, crazy one. And then we have, like, a waterproof one, and then there's, like, a lengthening Lash Love one, which I haven't tried that one yet. I haven't even tried the Lash Intensity one yet, to be honest. I sell more Lash Intensity than anything else. And then I'd say Lash Love next. And then when I do eyeshadow, I always do my mascara first, and then once I'm done with my eyeshadow, I'll do a, like, second coat, usually. Remember correctly, I think, Michelle, I think you've got the waterproof one. The waterproof Lash Love. And Amber, I'm pretty sure you tried this one, the Ultimate one. Okay, so now let's do some eyeshadow. And I don't know if you remember me saying in the beginning, I wanted to try to attempt that, like, similar look that one girl's photo I shared. My fellow Mary Kay friend. Hers was like, it's hers are the new eyeshadows, which I only have like one or two of the new ones, but it was like a pink, a blue, and a brown, which I do have our old pink color, and I have our old blue color, and I have our old brown color, so we'll see what we can do. But it was kind of like she took the brown was like kind of all over, the pink was like on the lid, and the blue was like underneath. So that's what I'm going to try to do here. Which most of our new eyeshadow colors are very similar to our old ones. The formula has just been updated, but then we do have some, like, brand new colors that we didn't have before as well. So if you had, like, a favorite eyeshadow color, don't freak out, because we probably still have it. It's just been revamped. Because the new eyeshadows are supposed to last, like, 12 hours or so. I don't know, like, a ridiculously long time. And then some are shimmer and some are matte. I always do one a little too much, and then the other one's smaller. Can never get them both just right. Okay. Now I'm gonna go in with that pink color. Which this was one of my favorite colors whenever I first started. And usually I don't like pink eyeshadows, but this one is so pretty. I think it was called Precious Pink, but it's some new name now. And as always, I'll take pictures afterward, so you can see it in different lighting. Which you can even do like a cut crease with this look, and it'd like really make the pink pop. But I'm just gonna blend it all together tonight. Okay, now I'm gonna do the blue under my eye. So I'm gonna use my brow brush. It has this little angle thing at the bottom. I'm gonna use that to do the blue underneath. One thing I like about doing a color on the bottom eyelid is, like, then you don't have to do eyeliner, unless you want to, of course. Kind of eliminates the need for eyeliner, and it's a little more forgiving than eyeliner is. So I start, like, in the middle, and work my way out. Definitely just stabbed my eyeball. See? That's cute. Time for the other side. So again, I start in the middle. Just kind of work my way out here. And this is why I didn't put my mascara on my bottom lashes yet. So it makes it easier to do this when you haven't done your mascara on the bottom yet. So yeah, if you're not amazing at makeup or eyeshadow, that's a little trick you can do that makes it look really cute. I definitely got some of that. Okay, now I'll put some, like I said, I'm gonna second coat my mascara. I'm not gonna do any eyeliner or anything tonight. And then I'm gonna coat my bottom lashes too. And if you like really want to clean it up, you can always take concealer too if you wanted to. And then I've never been good at mascara, so when you do your bottom like that, it kind of like hides any imperfections you may have done with your mascara. Second coat on these guys. Done lip liner in a while either, so let's do that first. I wanted to try lip liner with my new limited edition matte lipsticks. Again, I used my Mary Kay palette. We have three now. We have that little fall limited edition one that holds four, and then we have this one, obviously, which is the big one, and then we have like a medium size one, I guess you could say. But the medium one has like flower rose design on it, which is super cute. But I got the big one because I was, you know, trying to fill that bad boy up. Anyway, so this is lip liner in deep nude. So it's a little on the darker side, but I prefer my lips darker, so that's just me. But we have a bunch of lip liner colors. We have like the light nude, medium nude, deep nude, and then we have like a red one, a purple one, a coral one, chocolate one. Okay. Make sure I grab my lip liner and not my eyebrow liner. But like the 90s darker lip liner look is coming back anyways, so. And then I think it's called like Tuscan Rose, or hold on, let's see what it's called. Spice of Life. I was really off. But in my opinion, it's like a neutral red color. That's like the best way I can describe it. But there's this one, and then there's like a brown beige one. And those are our two limited edition. I've posted them a couple times, so if you want to check them out, you can look at the catalog and the albums, or you can just scroll down and it's going to be one of the first couple things, probably. And I did a video where I used this with no lip liner, but I've been wanting to see what it looks like with my lip liner. So there we go. Maybe I should have left it up. Oh well. Like I said, I'll take pictures when I'm done. So yeah, that's the final look. Kind of touched on contouring, did some eyeshadow, lipstick, lip liner. I kind of touched a bunch of bases, I feel like, tonight. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I know it's getting late, so I'll let you all go. I'll post a little or some pictures in a little bit. And yeah, so that's pretty much it. Hope you liked it. I really like the blue underneath. I think that's a neat little trick. So yeah, hope everybody has a good night and a great weekend. And thanks for watching. Bye.